So let's say you suspect you have Adware on your Mac. So Adware is not as serious as some malware. It's not really stealing your information or doing harm to your computer, but it's showing you ads everywhere and it's annoying and you shouldn't have it on your Mac. Of course, the way to avoid that is to make sure you only download software from sites you trust and to research software before you download it. But once you have it and you want to get rid of it, you can look in some general places and do some general things that will get rid of most kinds of adware. If you can identify the kind of adware you've got, the best thing to do is to Google that with the keywords Mac remove and the name of the adware, and usually you'll come up with some site that gives you instructions. Matter of fact, it's best to look at several sites that give you instructions and see that they all agree before actually doing those things. But let's say you want to go and check in the usual places and try to clean up your Mac a little bit. So the first thing you want to do is you want to make sure you quit any apps that you're running, especially Safari. So you've quit that and you're out of all your apps. Now you're just going to be in the Finder here looking at your files. Now you're going to use the Go menu to go into your library. Now you click on Go and there is no library entry there. But if you hold the Option key down on your keyboard, library pops up, you select it, and now you're in your library, in your home folder. I'm going to choose Column View here so I can see things a little easier. So I see I'm in Library, and then here are the folders in Library, and one of them is something called Launch Agents. So you're going to look in here. I'm going to expand this column a bit so I can see these things. Now you're going to want to look and see what's in there and try to see if you can identify each item. So for instance, here's one that's obviously Spotify, and if you have Spotify installed, it's there, no problem. Skype, same thing. Dropbox, same thing. There's something from Adobe. I use lots of Adobe software, so I'm not surprised. I know that GC is their kind of software to make sure that I have licensed Adobe software on there. So all four of these check out. I know what they are. If you don't know what something is, you can always copy the file name and do a Google search on it. And usually you come up with somebody that's asked the question before and they say, oh, that's for Microsoft or whatever. And you say, yes, I have that software, so I know that's legitimate. But if you see the name of some adware or something you don't recognize, then that might be the culprit and you may want to delete that. Now also look, in addition to launch agents, look for something called launch daemons. And that's daemons spelled D-A-E. And that's kind of also another place where things that automatically get launched, started, start up are stored. Now in addition to your user folder here, you want to check the computer's system library. See, there are two libraries. There's a system library, which is for all users, and there's the user library, which is just for your user account. So I'm going to command click here on the top title bar here so I can go all the way back up to the hard drive level. And in the hard drive level I can see the system library, and I can go and see there is launch agents, and I can expand this column here as well and check out all of these things to make sure they check out. And I can look at launch daemons as well and check all these out as well. And I know what each one of these is. I mean, there's some stuff from Microsoft, there's my screen recording software, there's a bunch of things for Adobe, backup software, all things that I understand. But if you see the adware they're trying to get rid of listed here or something you don't recognize, then search for it and see if it's something you should delete. So that's your first step. The next thing you're going to want to do is go to System Preferences, and in there go to Users and Groups. Your user there should already be selected, so click on the padlock to authenticate. Go to Login Items. And then here you'll see some apps that will automatically start up when you log in. So make sure you can identify everything there. If not, search for it. Or if it's obviously the adware you're trying to get rid of, you can select it and then use the minus button here to delete it. Now it's time to look in Safari again. But instead of just launching Safari by clicking on Safari, you're going to hold the Shift key down as you do so. What this does is any windows that you had opened in the previous session of Safari will not reopen. So if something is kind of in a hidden window somewhere, it's going to be eliminated. So now you're back in Safari and you want to go to Safari Preferences. In Safari Preferences, there's a couple things you want to check. First, extensions. Go to Extensions here and it shows you a list of extensions. This is a place where sometimes if you have adware installed, it's going to be installed as a Safari extension. So you look through here and you make sure you identify everything. Here's the DuckDuckGo privacy extension. I did a tutorial on that a little while ago, which is why it's installed. I remember installing it. I know why it's there. I'm good. But if you look at the other things here, you may find something there that you don't know what it is, you can search for it, or maybe you find the thing that's obviously Adware and you can select it and delete it. Don't just deactivate it, but actually just uninstall it, like this uninstall button right here. Also, you can go in the General tab and there's Homepage here. So sometimes what Adware does is it changes the homepage on your browser. So even after you've uninstalled it completely, you notice that whenever you open up a new browser window, it goes to some weird search engine or some ad or something like that. So check what's here. I have it set to Wikipedia from a previous tutorial, but you may have it set to nothing or to Google or something like that. So just make sure that's something that you want there as your homepage. And one last general piece of advice. You may want to just, at this point, do an applications audit on your Mac. So in the Finder, open a new Finder window and you can click on Applications in the sidebar there, or Go and Applications, and look through all of the applications you see that you have installed. Just do it one by one. Take your time. Almost all of these, and probably all of them, are going to be just fine. You'll recognize them as something you've installed or something that should be there. If there's something you don't recognize, again, Google it, see what it is. Just don't blindly delete something that you're unsure about, because there's a lot of things in here that may not have the name you expect, or you may not have realized they're on your Mac. But if you see something that's obviously the piece of Adware you're dealing with, then you're going to want to clean it out of your applications folder, even if it's not set to launch automatically or do anything like that now. You don't want it on your Mac. So it's a good idea to just do an audit and look through here. I've got, you can see, 154 items in here. It wouldn't take me that long to get through them. And I'm a pro user that's been adding apps, and I have lots of apps for development and for video editing, for all sorts of things in here. So you probably have even less. And most of these will be things you recognize. There's iMovie, there's Word, there's Pixelmator, Acorn, all the stuff that you probably recognize right at a glance. So it would be quick to go through this and see what maybe shouldn't be there.